15 degrees later this week. Things are certainly heating up.
That's a golf club.
Yeah, the Ducks and Oilers, and things are heating up for this guy in the news for many reasons. Nail Yakupov requesting a trade from the Oilers. More on that throughout the night. Sean Horkoff returns to Edmonton for his final game at Rexall. Always a fan favorite when he played for the Oilers. Another fan favorite is where we begin. Gene Principe out at Rexall Place, ready to set the scene as he always does. Gene.
David, thank you very much. I hope, David, I know you got a couple little kids, and I hope the Easter Bunny hopped by and had some treats for them. But we move from Easter, and let's move forward to another bunny, Bugs Bunny. You know, one of his favorite lines, what a maroon! Well, I tell you what, this maroon the Edmonton Oilers got from Anaheim on trade deadline day has been nothing short of fantastic. I mean, a draft pick, and not even a high one, in order to get him into the lineup. One of Bugs Bunny's other favorite lines, what's up, Doc? Well, I'll tell you what's up with the line of Patrick Maroon, Connor McDavid, and Jordan Eberle. Their point totals, especially on the most recent road trip for the Edmonton Oilers. In fact, McDavid has points in seven straight, tying a career high, and Jordan Eberle has goals in three straight games. Well, for the Anaheim Ducks, the thing that they are chasing, well, the carrot dangling in front of them is top spot in the Pacific Division. Points back of Los Angeles, but they have a game in hand, so if they win tonight, well, the math is easy. It is down to one, and they get some good news because Ryan Kessler, who's been at home due to some personal issues, is back and ready to play tonight. Now, I will say, when Billy, John, and David talk, you might say I'm all ears. Back to you.
No, that doesn't deserve anything.
Nothing? No, not nothing. No, all right. Billy Jaffe and John Shannon.
You're a harsh critic.
Tough critic. Tough critic. We'll have more from Gene. Don't worry. Billy, let's start with you, though. What are we expecting? Something to keep an eye on tonight.
Well, keep an eye on Anaheim and see how they react. This is the last game of their five-game Canadian road trip. Mm-hmm. That's been a long trip for this team. They haven't been facing teams that have been giving them playoff-type atmospheres because the teams that they've all been playing are out of it. Now, the coaches want to see how they react. They want to see if they play that good, complete 60-minute hockey that got Anaheim back into the top of the division after that really brutal start earlier in the year, John. If they can play the right way, the Anaheim coaches are going to be happy.
Well, you're going to see their depth down the middle. I mean, their depth is unbelievable. When you consider that Nate Thompson, always a center, is actually going to go and play the wing today because Horkoff, Raquel, Getzlaff and Kessler are there. It's absolutely remarkable. As far as the Oilers are concerned, Gene talked about how good the McDavid line has been. There needs to be more from other lines. And we know that the Nail Yakupov story will continue, and Todd McClellan's going to give Yakupov a chance to play with Leon Draisaitl and Taylor Hall tonight. Let's see if he can come up and make a difference.
Really quickly, what kind of reaction are you expecting for Yakupov? Really quickly here.
Not good.
Not great. No.
No. Some booze, hey? People never like when a player
almost
is
almost as bad as some
time.
Of Gene's lines.
Oh, we'll leave
Gene,
you with that.
I loved it, buddy. I loved it. The professor over
Kevin
here.
Kevin Quinn, Drew Amenda, and Gene Principe will have your first
of the NHL. It is the 50th start of the season for Cam Talbot. A win will match the career-high 21 victories he had with the Rangers last year. Talbot 7-3 in the month of March. And at the other end, 22-year-old John Gibson has the best goals against of any rookie in the National Hockey League. Only Mike Condon has more rookie wins. But it was Frederik Andersen who was in the nets as Anaheim defeated Ottawa 4-3 on Saturday in overtime. They had to come back to do it. The Oilers dropped a 6-4 decision in Los Angeles. And Drew, the Oilers playing in the Pacific Division want to have a say as to who ends up on top.
Another motivating factor for the guys. When you're searching for things to motivate yourself at the end of the year, this should be it.
Ryan Kessler is back in the lineup after missing a couple for personal reasons. He will be the guy in the face of Connor McDavid tonight. He is with Cogliano and Silverberg. Talbot plays it over to Fane. It gets by him. Cogliano on the intercept. Eberle, of course, with Patrick Maroon, the former Anaheim Duck. McDavid with the puck now, moving in against Stoner. Gibson clears it away, kept in by Eberle. Maroon takes a bump from Kessler as he sends it around the near board. Patrick Maroon on the pass to McDavid. Puck squirts free, hits the side of the net. Now it comes back to Reinhardt at the point. He'll go across to Oster. Lets the shot go. Didn't make it through. The Anaheim Ducks are 3 points behind L.A. for top spot in the Pacific Division. L.A. in San Jose tonight. Nail Yakupov was the subject of media scrutiny today is on the ice with Draisaitl and Hall. Draisaitl from the corner being watched by Hampus Lindholm. Draisaitl behind the net, centers it out in front. Hall's got it now. He'll give it to Yakupov. Yakupov to Clendenning, snaps a shot that goes off the end boards, picked up by Draisaitl. Leon Draisaitl being watched by Lindholm again. Hall's got it from the corner. He is checked, and Rickard Rakell trying to get free. Yakupov has an odd angle on that stick. Now he'll get it correct as the puck comes down into Oilers territory.
I'm confused.
Hall moving in with Yakupov. Yakupov snaps the shot, and Gibson makes the save. He'll hang on.
Yeah, that's the hold it to right end there.
Let's take a look at the keys to the game. They're brought to you by Ford, official automotive partner of the Edmonton Oilers.
Against this team, you've got to have discipline. Discipline in the details of the game and how you're supposed to play the game, but also discipline to stay out of the box and maintain the point production. By point, we mean the defensemen. 106 points from their defensemen this year of the Anaheim Ducks. They're a team that likes to bring that back in rush.
Cam Fowler goes cross ice, intended for Getzlaff, who's out there with Brandon Peary and Chris Stewart. Chris Stewart missing 20 games with a broken jaw. He is wearing the full face shield. Kropotkowski, Kassian, and Letessu are up front for the Oilers. Vetra and Fain back on the blue line. Jay Theodore finds Brandon Peary. Peary goes cross ice to Getzlaff. It goes off his skate. Racing after it is Stewart. He comes together with Vetra. Fain around the boards. Just out of the reach. Kassian does eventually catch up to it at the end of his shift. Adam Cracknell is out there with Lander and Hendricks. Lander back in the lineup, not dressing the last two. Adam Cracknell getting an opportunity in the absence of Iiro Pakarinen. Osterlin goes right up the middle for Cracknell. He'll play it off the boards. Gibson will slow it down there for Stoner around the board. Sammy Botman is on the blue line for the Ducks. He has missed 8 games with a head injury. Right out in front it comes, and there he is making a defensive play on Matt Hendricks. Kept in by Reinhardt. Hendricks behind the net. Knocked down by Clayton Stoner. Ryan Garbin right back in front. Hendricks trying to take advantage, but it is Botman who skates it away. Thompson sends it around the boards. Hall will play it back for Osterley behind the net. Just one shot so far, and it's been taken by the Oilers. It was Nail Yakupov. Osterley in the corner gets hit hard by Peary. Cogliano centering pass. Draisaitl back defensively. Puck comes right out in front as the Oilers trying to get out from behind their own net. Draisaitl goes cross ice. Osterley tip pass to Yakupov. He'll play it to the middle. It is picked off there by Hampus Lindholm. Now to Rakell. He'll push it across. Peary out in front. Trying to find Jamie McGinn. Draisaitl back the other way. Draisaitl checked by Manson. Lindholm picks it up. Right up the middle for Rakell. Here comes Peary. Peary winds, scores. Corey Perry's got 31 goals on the season, and he's got the first goal on the first shot by the Anaheim Ducks.
Beautiful, beautiful breakout. Just one little touch pass as the Oilers want to put some pressure on. They're going to break the puck out. Hampus Lindholm turns. Quick up. One touch pass to the outside on a bad pinch, and that creates the two-on-one. One of the best goal scorers in the National Hockey League. Head up all the way. Absolutely perfectly placed shot. Wow, that is a great shot by Corey Peary on a beautiful breakout execution from one zone to the next.
A six-time 30-goal scorer. He came into the game tied for 11th in goals. And offside is the call at the Oilers blue line. Jamie McGinn and Rickard Rakell get the assist. Jamie McGinn has made an impact in 14 games. He's got 10 points in a Duck uniform.
Jamie McGinn will do that. He's an excellent player, real earnest guy. That's just high-level talent right there. Cam Talbot's got the angle. He's out. He's challenging. But you got Corey Peary coming down at you with all the time in the world. He's going to, more times than not, blow by a goalie.
Corey Peary now on a four-game point streak. Everly with Maroon. Lets the shot go. It was blocked by Fowler. Picked up by Maroon. Everly to Maroon. Maroon plays it down low for McDavid. Connor McDavid works it back to the point. Nurse ends up on the stick of Maroon. He was checked by Kessler. Ryan Kessler drops it back. McDavid intercepts it. McDavid back up top for Nurse. Nurse throws it through traffic. The puck sits there. McDavid dishes off. Second run knocked down by Cogliano. He'll give it to Jakob Silverberg. Works his way in by Nurse. Nurse drives him hard into the boards. Andrew Cogliano playing in his 697th straight game. Getzlaf waits for it on the near side. He will give it to Brandon Peary. Peary back to Getzlaf, the captain of the Ducks, against Darnell Nurse. Stewart couldn't do anything with it. The Oilers able to get it down the ice. They will quickly get a change in. 14:30 left to go here in the first period. Each team has one shot. The Ducks have one goal. Letestu plays it off the boards. Racing after it is Cassian against Lindholm. Letestu in there to dig along with Josh Manson.
Let's go, no whistle.
No whistle. You hear the referee say play on. And eventually it will come to Getzlaf.
Heads up, boys. Heads up.
He'll flip it high for Chris Stewart. Stewart cut out there by Reinhardt. He'll get the puck to Cassian. Now to Korpikoski, checked immediately there by Sean Horkoff. Sean Horkoff along with Andrew Cogliano. As we're talking about memories in this building, two former Oilers here playing for the last time.
Andrew Cogliano, as you mentioned, hasn't missed a game since he started with the Oilers.
Horkoff is checked by Cracknell and knocks him down. Cracknell, nice pass over to Sekera. His shot is blocked by Thompson. Another shot right out in front. A great chance there for Adam Cracknell. Cracknell behind the net for Hendricks. Penalty coming up to the Ducks. Anton Lander back to the point for Fane. Hall is over the boards. Here is Sekera. Sekera down low, right out in front of him. Snapping a shot is Cracknell, and coming across to make the save was John Gibson. Corey Perry has the game's first goal. It's Rogers Oilers hockey right here on Sportsnet. And the Oilers will get the first power play of this game. The topic du jour, Drew, I want you to weigh in on that, is Neil Yakupov requesting a trade. What do you think?
I was as shocked as when I heard Barry Bonds is on steroids. I mean, come on. I mean, this should not be surprising to anybody. And I don't think it's that big of a deal. The Edmonton Oilers aren't happy. Neil Yakupov and his agent aren't happy. And like Todd McClellan said, there's two sides to that pancake. So Neil Yakupov needs a fresh start somewhere else. But he has to make sure he ups his worth to other teams by playing hard these last number of games.
Not out there to start this power play as Osterley gives it to Eberle.
2 minutes for roughing.
Back to Osterley at the point.
6 minutes, 54 seconds.
Jordan Eberle. Nice catch with Osterley to the middle it goes. Here is Eberle, fires a shot. Hall providing the screen. Gibson makes the save. This is the number one penalty killing team in the league. The Anaheim Ducks special teams are number one in both departments. Oilers 1-for-4 in that game against Los Angeles. Osterley at the point. Up against Ryan Kessler. Eberle gets it back. McDavid now down low out in front for Dreisaitl. Gets by him. Osterley's shot gets sent into the corner by Silverberg. Hall moves out in front. Jams one that's stopped by Gibson. And this puck is sent down the ice by Jakob Silverberg.
Good chances against, as you mentioned, the number one penalty kill in the National Hockey League. Credit assistant coach Trent Yanni for how good the Ducks are when they're a man down.
86.6% efficiency coming into this one. Sekera will chip it in. The Oilers have scored three power play goals in the season series so far. This is their 13th chance with a man advantage. Letestu hammers a shot that is blocked by Clayton Stoner. And then finished off by Sammy Vatanen. 40 seconds left to go on the penalty to Garvin. Oilers with four shots, the Ducks with just one. Yakupov stopped. Thompson sends it down the ice.
Neil Yakupov comes off with bad body language. You got to come off, even if you make a mistake like that, you've got to come off not showing your teammates that you're defeated.
Oilers under pressure now as Thompson on the steal for Pekoski. Couldn't get it away from him. Thompson, the end of the shift, will play it back to Hampus Lindholm. He will give it to
Manson get it back again. Gets Lab with a pass to Perry. Doesn't work. Clendenning goes right up the middle. Unable to get going was Hendricks. Two shots for the Oilers on that power play. They are 0 for 1.
So earlier on the power play, the first power play unit comes out. They get a couple of dynamite chances. Right away, they're thinking, get the puck to the net. Aggressive to the net. Taylor Hall just misses. The puck comes underneath and then down low again. Aggressive to the net by Taylor Hall. Smart play. Bank it off the pads and then walk out and try to pick up your own rebound.
John Gibson has had good success in the Pacific Division. He is 9-2 so far. Face-off win for Lander. Cracknell gets it back to Reinhardt. Trying to sift that puck through, and he couldn't get it. The go by Garbutt. Perry with it now. Perry holds onto it. Perry still has it. Feeds it up to Fowler. His shot stopped by Talbot. Corey Perry may have those goal legs we've heard about.
Yep.
He got the only goal so far.
And again, the defense. We talked about the fourth key to the game for the Anaheim Ducks. Points from the point. Cam Fowler walks in, and that's what will happen is that the Ducks are so good down low. You'll draw defenders down low, and everybody, of course, gets down below the top of the faceoff circle. Cam Fowler reads it, take the space available, but Cam Talbot, nice stop.
And the rich get richer with the coming back of Sammy Vatanen, who's got 37 points on the season. From the faceoff, the Oilers win the draw. And that puck ends up in the Oilers bench.
So here are the numbers from the defense for the Anaheim Ducks. One of the reasons they are a good team and they're making their way up to the top of the Pacific Division. The last 15 wins, look at their production. 12 goals, 42 assists, 54 points. That's absolutely amazing. The points per game, even more so. And Cam Fowler is leading the way. He's a heck of a defenseman. He can skate. He's good defending. And that's the one thing the Ducks haven't given up is the defense aspect of their game versus the offensive aspect.
Tied for second in goals against. They give up just 2.34 per game. Jamie McGinn laid it back. Yakupov picks it off. Starts away with Draisaitl. Leon Draisaitl across the blue line. He will stop. Out in front for Hall. Hall. Sekera walks in. His shot stopped by Gibson. Andre Sekera allowed to move right in and get that shot away. Ricard Raquel. Nice move around Hall. Raquel stopped by Talbot. He will cover and get the whistle.
Century Casino, welcome to the winner's zone.
Time to play Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Oilers player scores 5 goals in tonight's game, Raid Vukadin of Edmonton could win $1 million. Shop at Safeway, you could be our next lucky winner right here on Sportsnet.
Right here, the Oilers will try and win a draw against the team that is ranked 4th in the league. When it comes to the circle, they have the best faceoff man in the NHL, named Ryan Kessler. 59% success. But the Oilers have possession. Nurse sends it around the boards. Gibson will stop it up behind the net, play it himself. Picked off there by Eberle, who gets knocked down by Fowler. Or that knocked down by Stoner, I should say, as Vatanen plays it to Silverberg. Pass for Silverberg off the stick of the captain, doesn't work. And that'll go back down into Anaheim territory.
Todd McClellan talking today when asked about the Nail Yakupov situation. He said, you know what, I really don't have a comment on that. He talked a little bit about, you know, did he really say it? And then the translation. The other thing he mentioned was, it's not about the individual. It's about the team. And it always will be about the team for as long as he's there behind the bench with the Oilers. So you have to make sure that the team comes first.
Their shot is stopped by Gibson. Pagliano will send that down the ice. Reinhardt back, and another icing call against the Anaheim Ducks.
People talking coaches of the year. You have to look at Bruce Boudreau. I don't know, of course, Barry Trotz is the runaway favorite because his Capitals have done so well, but the guy that used to be behind the Capitals bench, Bruce Boudreau, has done a really good job this year. He and his entire coaching staff of Paul McClain, the great Trent Yanni, and Rich Preston, they took a team that was not even close to being in the playoffs, and now are struggling to try to get to the top of the division. Amazing.
They were 1-7-2 in the month of October. February, they really caught fire. They lost just one game in regulation in the month of February, went 12-1-1, and everybody talks about Christmas. 29-8-4 since then.
And they did it by becoming a good, structured defensive team.
Silverberg. Talbot steers that away. Everly picks it up on the far side. Outlet pass for McDavid just out of his reach. Reinhardt will play it back to Osterley. Osterley across to Reinhardt. Maroon moving in against Hampus Lindholm, gets the puck to McDavid. McDavid watched by Kessler. They tie up in behind the net. The puck does come free and it's picked up by Manson. Under 9 minutes left to go in the first period. Ryan Garbutt got there ahead of Andre Sekera, but Cassian comes back and starts the Oilers back the other way. Nice move to get around Horkov. Now to Letestu. Letestu back to Cassian, and a great save by John Gibson.
Nice play there by Cassian and Letestu.
Zach Cassian playing in his 33rd game. Glendening around the boards. Brandon Perry waiting for it there. He'll feed it to Stewart. Stewart gets bumped into by Cracknell. Glendening. Just outside the Oilers bench. The Oilers want to get a change and will. Gets left, drifts back into his own zone. It was almost deja vu all over again with Cracknell trying to imitate Connor McDavid and what he did against Vinny LeCavalier on Saturday.
Quick stick.
7:40 to go here in the period. Darnell Nurse. Wrapped in there by Anton Lander, stopped by Gibson, and the rookie, Drew, handles the puck pretty well.
Very well. Gets out for a big man, gets out there quick and moves it efficiently.
Big rebound given up there, though, but Raquel sends it down the ice. Dreisaitl, excellent in the faceoff circle in that game against Los Angeles, won 13 of the 17 draws he took. Hall, checked by Vatanen. Pass to Yakupov. Yakupov goes cross ice, trying to find Dreisaitl. Leon Dreisaitl back to Hall, and that was broken up before it could get through by Vatanen. Raquel, across the line, takes a hit from Fane. Talbot plays it himself, and he gets it to Hall. Hall to Dreisaitl. Leon Dreisaitl with Nail Yakupov. Stoner given a bump. Dreisaitl hit as well by Vatanen. Puck comes around to the near side and it gets by Reinhardt. The race is on. The speedy Cogliano was there, but Reinhardt got a stick on it. Lindholm brings it in. A wrist shot that goes off Osterley. Follows up on the rebound. Opportunity in front for Silverberg. The puck is still loose. Snow Angel time for Talbot. It's still alive. Opportunity for Silverberg is blocked. They don't ask you how, Drew. They just ask you how many.
That's a heck of a block by Jordan Eberle. Wow, that was going in the net.
Mathis Lindholm pushes it ahead for Manson. He wants to get it out. It hits the linesman. Comes back to Lindholm. This is Cogliano. Cogliano. Pass intercepted by Patrick Maroon. Outlet pass just out of the reach of Connor McDavid. And icing against the Oilers.
That's a long time without a whistle. We had a couple of things happening during that time. First off, Zach Cassian, nice move in the neutral zone right there. Kick it to the outside, drive the net, shot while the man is driving. Shot pass, I should say, Mark Letestu, terrific save. And there's Jordan Eberle. He's struggling. Puck gets freed, and Jordan Eberle gets right in the shooting lane on Jakob Silverberg. Extra effort, my number 14. A good goal scorer, not bad at keeping him out either.
Oilers seventh in the league in block shots coming in. Eberle tips that puck out to center. Fired right back in by Shea Theodore. Here's Eberle. End of the shift, dumps that puck down into duck territory. Theodore given a bump by Letestu. Peary with Stewart and Getzlaff. Fane takes a hit as he gets the puck to Cassian right up the middle. Picked up by Korbakoski. Outlet pass for Letestu was broken up by Fowler. Gets left back into his own zone. The Anaheim Ducks, 12th time they have qualified for the playoffs. They are the three-time defending Pacific Division champions. Garbin is stopped, carries on, goes cross ice, looking for Stoner. That pass too hard to handle. Eight shots for the Oilers, seven for the Ducks. Osterley, nice pass to Lander. Anton Lander centers, and it comes right to Gibson. No rebound for Matt Hendricks. It's Rogers, Oilers hockey from Rexall Place, and it's right here on Sportsnet.
Tonight, but they were once on the same team, and in fact, the same show between two Zambonis.
Have you ever accidentally misspelled your name while signing an autograph for a kid and wrote moron?
The answer was no, but give Kessler credit because he got Maroon to play patty cake as well during that segment.
That's very good.
That's awesome. Very well done.
Sean Horkoff against Connor McDavid. Horkoff wins the draw. 4:40 left to go in the period. Lindholm plays it off the boards, down the ice. That will chase Osterley back into his own zone, and that's going to be another icing call.
You know your business. We know how to protect it. Inside Insurance, specializing in the oil and gas and construction industries. InsideInsurance.ca.
Patrick Maroon's numbers with Anaheim and now with the Edmonton Oilers this season. A lot has been made about Patrick Maroon playing with Connor McDavid, but Todd McClellan talked about his leadership ability and the fact of how good of a teammate he is. And when you talk to the guys, they agree.
Great spin move there by Eberle, and then he gets hit hard into the net by Ryan Kessler. And that took the net off the mooring.
Jordan Eberle having a look at the referee going, I didn't have the puck. Would he hit me? But I like the aggressiveness of taking the puck to the net when you have the opportunity. Jordan Eberle makes a terrific little spin move, and now he's going to drive. The puck is gone. It's behind the net. And then Ryan Kessler hits him. That's what the conversation, or at least the comment from Jordan Eberle was at one of the officials. Aggressive nature in taking the puck to the net and the aggressive nature of Ryan Kessler is always on display.
Eberle and Hall tied for the team lead in goals. Each guy has 25. And Jordan Eberle's on a three-game goal streak coming into this one. Yakupov, Draisaitl, and Hall are out there with Nurse and Clendenning. Horkoff wins another draw. Lindholm plays it off the glass. And that puck goes into touch, as they say in football games.
A little bit of work for Ryan Kessler being done and missed the last couple of games as for personal reasons, but that is a guy that when it comes playoff time, he is going to be in that third line center role, and he is going to be shadowing every other team's top player, which you're going to see a lot of McDavid versus Kessler tonight.
And even in that role, has still produced 17 goals. Shot by Hall doesn't get through. It sits there for Gibson, and he will cover.
Taylor Hall, he hurt his hand on this shot, or at least his a finger on the hand. He's able to knock the puck down, then he shot it, and then he got slashed right there as he's going to the net. Hampus Lindholm is looking to take a whack at a guy, and he hits Taylor Hall on the fingers, and Taylor Hall had to go back to the bench for a second. That stung.
Hall remains fifth in the league in shots, comes in with 274. Faceoff win by Draisaitl. Yakupov tried to get a shot away. It was blocked. Horkoff checked by Fain, who sends the Duck back into their own zone. Fowler around the boards for Theodore, gets by him. Hall gets by Raquel and gets the puck. All the way back up top it comes. Fain will give it to Sekera. Sekera, slap pass. And that got by Hall as he was tied up in front. Yakupov feeds it down low for Hall. Hall gets tripped up by Sean Horkoff. Play continues. Draisaitl checked by Horkoff. Puck is alive. Sekera down below the red line. Pushed away by Raquel as the Ducks want to get a change. 3:20 left to go here in the first period for Prokoski. Cassian and Letestu up there now as Gibson around the boards it goes. Stewart across the line. Chris Stewart. A backhand handled by Talbot. Getzlaff in the corner now. Getzlaff down low for Stewart. He's got Peary with him. Brandon Peary with the puck now. A sharp angle shot goes off of Reinhardt. And that one ends up in the sixth row. Taylor Hall. You be the referee. We'll be back.
Wants to send you to the 2016 NHL entry draft in Buffalo. Submit a 15-second video on social media showing how you would sweat to get to the draft. Visit Oilers social media channels and use hashtag sweatbetter for details.
Lander against Kessler, right off the draw. Gets lapped. Drops it back for Peary. Now, Kessler, after winning that draw, will go to the bench, and Chris Stewart hops over the boards. Batman reaching for it. It is Cracknell who sends it in. Gibson stops it for Cam Fowler. He'll give it to Sammy Vatanen. Play it off the boards for Chris Stewart. Stewart for Peary. Brandon Peary knocked down by Lander. Cracknell with the puck now. Cracknell to the corner. Fowler plays it off the boards. The owner's able to keep it in, and it's Adam Cracknell. He is checked by Peary. Peary goes cross ice for Getzlaff. Here's Ryan Getzlaff. Shot was blocked by Reinhardt. Lander with it now. Lander to Nurse. Nurse flips it in. Everybody's going to change. Under 2 minutes left to go. Lindholm. The glass, it comes to Kessler. He'll get it to Silverberg. To Cogliano. Cogliano across the middle. Cogliano down low for Silverberg. He is checked by Fane. Cogliano plays it around the boards. And it gets by Hampus Lindholm, chasing back into his own zone. 10 shots for the Oilers, 8 for the Ducks. Silverberg, drop pass, Kessler. Kessler out in front for Cogliano, who's tied up there by Patrick Maroon as he drove to the front of the net. Kessler again. Stopped by Reinhardt. Trying to dig it free is Patrick Maroon, but it is McGinn who gets it to Theodore. Theodore, a wrist shot tipped by McGinn, stopped by Talbot.
This line, as John and Billy talked about with David Amber in the studio before the game, with Jamie McGinn on this line, it changes everything. Jamie's a big body, and he knows how to go to the net, and he's worked on his hands. He always is able to get to the net and then get his stick down. He's got a heavy stick because he's a big, strong guy, and there are the numbers with Raquel and Jamie McGinn. 21 goals this season. His previous high was 19. He played for Todd McCullen. Played for Todd McCullen, Jay Woodcroft, and Jimmy Johnson in San Jose, and they loved him as a hockey player.
Less than a minute to go in the first period. Raquel, McGinn, and Peary stay out there as Osterley is checked by Peary. He'll get it back to his D partner, Griffin Reinhardt. Yakupov chops it out to center. Fowler's going to bring it in with a pass to McGinn. McGinn throws it towards the net. That goes wide. Peary on the far side. Down low, Osterley takes a hit from Ricard Raquel. Hall to Yakupov. Back to Hall. Hall going wide. Dreisaitl could not get a good shot away. And the Ducks clear it down the ice. Sekera to Nurse. 10 seconds on the clock. Nurse hit the linesman with that. Now he has to wait. And the linesman shaking his head. A few words Mark Wheeler has for the rookie. First period comes to an end. Just one goal, and it is their leading goal getter, David Amber. Corey Perry, another 30-goal season.
And your 50-50 ticket.
not in goals, but at least in play as they trail by one after one. Joined by Louis DeBrusque, Mark Spector. And Louis, for all the times I've watched Connor McDavid on TV when he was on Sportsnet in the CHL, I could see that he could skate fast, but boy, if there's one thing I'll remember about this year when it comes to Connor, is his skating. What is it about him that makes him the way he is?
Well, he's an amazing skater. There's no question about that. And, you know, coming into the league, we all knew that he was really fast. But there's certain things you have to adjust to when you get to the National Hockey League. And I think he's adjusted remarkably considering the short amount of time that he's played the game. Because he's such a great skater, if you look early in the season, you watch him, you're pushing yourself to the absolute max every time you're on the ice. He's blistering fast, right? But a little bit out of control. You watch him and he's, you know, he's getting the strides going. He still looks great. But as of late, I've seen a little bit of a difference in his stride. And I talked to him this morning about it. He's just more powerful. He's taking a little bit longer strides. Look how smooth he is with the puck. Like, it's almost like it's effortless now for him to skate that way. And because he's digging in, that's what he said. He said he doesn't consciously think that he's doing anything differently skating, but he certainly is digging in more. And that's what he said has been a real difference for him. It's a higher level. The guys are bigger. They're stronger. You dig in more purposefully. And boy, is it ever showing in a stride. Just looks great.
I talked to guys in the other rooms about him. And I talked to Sean Horkoff today. We were laughing. We said, Sean, you're getting so old. You're near 1,000 games. Everyone must skate like McDavid for you. He goes, no, everyone doesn't skate like McDavid. He skates like McDavid. Yeah. Even the guys in the other room, Gino, they're all shaking their heads here.
Yeah, it's a quality that I have not quite seen, I don't think, in a player, the way Connor skates.
And you didn't think that he would get faster, but he indeed has. He's gotten better. Yeah. He actually has gotten better this year.
At his skating. Yep. For all those kids out there, always work on even things that you're great at. Darnell Nurse has started to be great at a few things. He's had kind of a different first period for him.
Yeah, well, he drilled a linesman at the end of it.
That's a touchy subject these
days,
too.
Listen, there's a lot of stuff that you can learn in hockey, and yet veterans are out for this reason. This is at the end of the period. Watch Darnell Nurse. Goes to shoot it in, he drills a linesman, right? Had all week long not to hit him, but he did. Now, what's this? They're skating off the ice after the buzzer. Mark Letestu says, Darnell, get back over there and apologize to that linesman. Because, you know what? The guy's just trying to get his job done, too. You drilled him with a puck. Darnell says, you know what? You're smart. I'm going to do that. And that's just part of being a young player. These guys are working, too, Louis. They're trying to make a buck. They're trying to get out of your way. The linesman's got to go somewhere. And Darnell hits him. You've been there. Yeah. How come you do that?
I love that leadership by Letestu to say, go over there and just say, sorry, you didn't mean to do that. Listen, when you're cordial with the referees, when you just be professional and polite to them, they're less likely to give you a penalty. Guys that I knew and I talked to on a regular basis, they might let it slide the odd time, but if you don't and you're nasty to them, you're going to get more calls called your way. It's just the way it works. So nice move there by Letestu to get a youngster to go over and say sorry.
Yeah, Nurse and Letestu on the mark. In different ways in that first period of play. The Oilers hoping to hit the mark in period number two. If they can close the gap on Anaheim, with the call on the way will be Drew and Kevin.
A 31st goal of the year, and seems to get 30 every single year. He plays from Jamie McGinn and Ricard Raquel on a beautiful play. Oilers outshoot the Ducks 10-9. Pretty even period except for that goal.
Ryan Kessler, the number one faceoff man in the league, won one of the six draws he took. The rookie, Connor McDavid, won seven of the nine he took.
And Louis just kept saying he keeps getting better. He keeps getting better at every aspect of his NHL game.
Andre Sekera has the puck right now, played over 9 minutes in that first period. Maroon sends it in, Theodore and Fowler on the blue line. As the puck comes out to Sekera, he'll give it to Maroon. Maroon to the near side for Eberle. Jordan Eberle flips it ahead for McDavid. Kessler is right beside him. Kessler with the puck now. Given a bump there by Maroon as he gets the puck to Shea Theodore. Theodore dishes off to Cogliano. Cogliano's shot goes wide. Maroon picks it up on the far side. He'll play it to the middle. McDavid moving in against Fowler. McDavid with a button hook. Eberle picks it up. Back to Reinhardt. Lets the shot go. And Gibson makes the first save.
We talked about Connor McDavid earlier about playoff teams. He wasn't having the production that he would hope. In the last six games versus playoff teams, four games versus playoff teams, I should say, he's had 6 points. Unbelievable that this kid, again, continues to evolve as a player this short into his NHL career.
42 games now, not quite complete 42. He is fourth in the league when it comes to rookie points. And only Patrick team scores more points per game as Peary lets the shot go and it goes into the corner. Squirts out in front. Reinhardt will pick it up. Hall. Pass intercepted by Getzlaff. Now to Peary. Right up the middle is Stewart. Short pass to Peary, but there is Hall coming back defensively. Cuts right in front of his own net. Drysdale. Across the line, and offside is the call.
Even though the Oilers overall in this building have a winning record against the Ducks, the last 17 games at Rexall have been in the Ducks' favor in a very heavy, heavy way in absolutely every aspect. Win-loss record, the power play, the goals allowed, the goals scored, it has been all Anaheim.
Oilers trying to snap a four-game losing streak against the Ducks in this building. Cassian right out in front. Out of the near side, Stoner takes the hit from Cassian as he gets the puck out, chasing Clendenning back into his own zone. Clendenning dishes to Letestu. Mark Letestu sends it around the boards. John Gibson stops it, lays it off the glass by Letestu, and it comes to Corey Perry. Bumped there by Clendenning. Nurse has Raquel on him as he drops it back for Letestu. As for Cassian, got by him, and that's going to be icing against the Oilers.
Adam Clendenning has been getting better and better every game as well, but this one right here, Corey Perry thought there should have been an interference call on that. He pretty much got an argument. He squeezes Corey Perry up pretty much without even getting a chance to get to the puck, moving out of his lane in order to do it. But we saw a few let go on the Oilers' side. We'll see a couple let go on the Ducks' side.
Horkoff wins the draw. Fowler with a wrist shot, and that one goes wide. Thompson. Horkoff. Garbutt. Garbutt. Swing and a miss. Fowler's got it. Cassian doesn't have a stick. Fowler's shot. Stopped by Talbot. On the near side, it's Garbutt again. Garbutt plays it behind the net. Gets by Horkoff. Waiting for it is Cam Fowler. He and Theodore are on the blue line. Ryan Garbutt. Cycles for Sean Horkoff. Horkoff knocked down. Gets the puck to Nate Thompson. Works it back to Fowler. Cam Fowler. And that puck goes up and out off of Lauri Korpikoski.
Well, Kev, you talked about the faceoff prowess of the Anaheim Ducks to win the faceoff here, and a double deflection that Cam Talbot doesn't even see, but Sturt gets in front of, and then there's Fowler again. Cam Fowler moving. Terrific footwork, just be moving, 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 and now he's got all kinds of time to get the shot on net, and there, that kind of shot is the off-the-pads to somebody else shot. He's not looking to score there. He's looking to get a rebound.
Cam Fowler missed 13 games this season with a knee injury. They are still missing David Perron. He is out with a shoulder problem.
Man, how good has David Perron played for the Ducks since he got there?
Adam Cracklin sends it around the boards. Lander on the far side with Hendricks. Hendricks will come to the near side now. Racing over to keep it in is Mark Fain. He'll get it to Adam Cracklin. Cracklin being hounded by Getzlaff. Hit the referee. Ducksville can't get it out. Cracklin at the line. Long shot blockered by Gibson up into the netting.
You wouldn't do this yourself, so why would you wash your car yourself? Leave the dirty work to the experts. Bubbles, simply the best.
Well, a reminder that Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's telecast is Kellogg's or Cashy cereal.
They gave it against Kessler. This time it's won by Kessler. Jacob Silverberg. Talbot. For Reinhardt, just out of his reach, back to the point. Long shot by Manson. And handled by Talbot. No rebound for Andrew Cogliano.
A lot of shots going at Cam Talbot. 11-11 so far shots on, but all this year there's been a ton of rubber flying at the Oilers goaltender, but he has been terrific in his last 12 starts. He has gotten better and better. 8-3-1 in his last 12. Look at the goals against and his save percentage. You throw in the two two goose eggs that there as well. Cam Talbot has proven that he is definitely a number one goalie.
Gave up 3 goals on 26 shots in his last start in San Jose when he got that win. One of 5 victories he has against Pacific Division foes. Gibson, again around the boards. Hall cuts it off. Picked up by Raquel. He'll flip that to an open wing. Reinhardt waiting for it. He'll give it to Yakubov. He'll play it back to Nurse. Dreisaitl from his own zone. Leon Dreisaitl off the boards to try and get by Raquel. Carrying on is Yakubov. Yakubov spinning at the line. Yakubov now to Nurse. Nurse, a wrist shot through traffic. Deflected off Hall and just wide. Dreisaitl to Yakubov. Back to Dreisaitl. Back to Yakubov! Stopped by John Gibson. What a great give and go between Leon Dreisaitl and Nail Yakubov.
Some work down low. Like Taylor Hall in front of the net. He's going to escape. He's going to keep the play alive. Finds Leon Dreisaitl. Dreisaitl finds Nail Yakubov on a give and go and go. But look at the unbelievable flexibility of John Gibson. The big man gets down and he splits to take away the chance for Nail Yakubov. Don't like that though. You can't show the opposition that body language. Can't give him a hint that you're feeling a little bit defeated, a little bit down.
Pagliano to Silverberg. He's got Kessler flying the zone. Couldn't get it to him. McDavid plays it back to Fain. Fain around the boards, intercepted by Silverberg, but it's picked up by Eberle. He will start the rush for Sekera. Rips it around the boards. McDavid waiting for it. He will kick it to Eberle. Back in the corner. Fowler now to Cogliano. Through the middle comes Kessler. Kessler moving in. Kessler can't get the shot away. He'll play it back to the point. Theodore waiting for it there. Cogliano able to keep it in. He overskated it. Here comes McDavid with Maroon. That was the end of their shift. Maroon will head off. 14:30 left to go in the second period. Shots favor the Oilers by 1, 12-11. Silverberg avoids the hit from Nurse. Back up top it comes. Stoner able to keep it in against Cassian. Now an opportunity for Zach Cassian. Winds, fires, Gibson the save. And the rebound is cleared away by Sammy Botman. Korkov to Garbutt. Ryan Garbutt. Hampus Lindholm shot. Stopped by Cam Talbot. Glendening takes the hit from Korkov. Letestu for Korpakoski by him. Botman. Out of Korkov. He'll just backhand it in. Nurse says thank you very much. Letestu. Korpakoski. He is checked by Botman. Stoner. Botman works his way to the red line and then is turned back by Hendricks. He'll have to give it to Stoner to get it in. Nurse. Letestu around the boards for Hendricks. He'll flip that into the territory. Hampus Lindholm gets left with a hard backhand picked up by Stewart. Stewart going wide. Stewart's shot from a sharp angle. Goes off the glass on the near side, and it comes right to Hampus Lindholm. He'll go across to Josh Manson. That down low for Brandon Peary. Reinhardt behind the net. Getzlaff with it now. Right out in front it comes, and off the stick of Chris Stewart. Oof. Fired in by Hendricks over top of the net. Osterley swing and a miss, but there to keep it in is Matt Hendricks. Getzlaff wants to relieve the pressure, but he's not going to be able to get off the ice. That's going to be icing against Anaheim.
Zach Cassian has had some good chances, too, so far tonight. Nice little play by Connor McDavid. Heavy on the stick, gets it to Cassian. Good hard shot, but John Gibson well out of the net on the hard blast. Look at where he is. That almost beats him to the 7 hole, you know, between the arm and the pad.
Osterley, a wrist shot, went off of Hall. Lindholm plays it off the boards, looking for Stewart, can't get it out. Stewart gets another chance, he'll deliver to Peary. Send that puck in on to Talbot as the Ducks make changes. Dry backside for Yakubov. Cleared in. Fowler picks it up. Cam Fowler to Perry. Perry now to Raquel. Raquel in traffic is stopped. Corey Perry has to wait for Jamie McGinn to clear. Jordan Osterling. Near side for Yakubov. Yakubov goes cross ice. Dreisaitl. Can't get the pass to Hall, but Hall with the intercept. Out in front it comes. And unable to get his shot was Dreisaitl. McGinn quickly back the other day away with Theodore and Raquel. Bain to Hall. Hall to Yakubov. Yakubov flips it up in the air. Botnin waits for it to come down. He will circle as the Ducks get organized. Here is Silverberg off the end of his stick. Maroon gets stopped. Cleared into Oiler territory. Cogliano on the near side. Plays it to the middle. It was behind Kessler. Zekera to Maroon. Maroon trying to feed it through. Broken up by Botman. Picked up now by Clayton Stoner. Cogliano in the middle. Sends it in for Kessler. Broken up, and here come the Oilers back the other way. McDavid cuts to the middle. Drop pass for Maroon. Maroon moving in. Out in front. It comes for Glendinning. Backhand chance. And a penalty coming up. Cogliano is down, but the penalty will be against the Anaheim Ducks. Kessler has some words with Nurse. Glendinning now grabbing the jersey of Stoner.
This is one thing that the Oilers have now they didn't have earlier. Some pushback.
When we come back, the Oilers on the power play. Rogers, Oilers hockey. On the
four games to be played, and they're in a comfortable spot, both in the series and when they play at home. As I'm joined by Edmonton Oil Kings coach Steve Hamilton. In Brandon, and you win two in a row. I'm guessing you would have been happy with one, or are you ecstatic with two?
Yeah, it's we're grateful for the opportunity. I mean, when you have to play game 73 at the end of the year, you don't know how that's going to play out. And really a good effort to get ourselves to Brandon, and then we made the most of two pretty important games.
Now with the travel, it's a 2-3-2 series. Do you like that a lot, considering where you are in the series right now?
Yeah, it's a little bit unique with the distance to be covered and building availability and everything. So 2-3-2, the way it's gone, it's certainly a good opportunity for us.
What does the coach do on the 12-hour bus ride?
Oh, kill time, try and get some sleep, decompress, all the things that you'd try to do.
Steve, thanks. Congratulations on the two wins, and look forward to seeing a few more for your team.
Thanks very much, Gene.
All right, guys, back up to you.
Silverberg is in the penalty box. The Oilers on their second power play. McDavid back to Osterley. His shot is blocked by Kessler. Dreisaitl shot by Eberle, and that was Hampus Lindholm, who came over and got a piece of it.
That's a heck of a block, and one of the reasons that Hampus Lindholm is such a valuable young defenseman. The 13th block shot of the Ducks. A terrific pass. No look pass. Jordan Eberle fires as quickly as he possible can. There's the penalty, and there's the injury to Andrew Cogliano. The Iron Man, that'll take a little bit of a will of some iron to get back out on the ice after getting kicked in the stomach by your own guy. Ouch.
A minute 39 left to go in the penalty to Silverberg. The Oilers got two shots on their last power play. Hall with it now. Hall will dish off. McDavid in the corner, tied up there by Manson. Kessler now to Getzlaff. Getzlaff running some time off the clock, and he will finally send it down the ice. Osterley with McDavid. Hall. Dreisaitl. And of course, Jordan Eberle, who leads this team in power play goals. He's got 7 on the season. Fowler ties up with McDavid. The puck squirts free, and it's picked up by Cogliano. He's back out there, and he'll send it down the ice. Anaheim, number 1 in penalty killing in the league. They are 5th best on the road. Mark Letestu. Dishes off to Neil Yakubov. He snaps a shot, and that one rises over top of John Gibson. Quick release by Neil Yakubov. Garbage, shorthanded. out there with Getzlaff. Back comes Letestu. Letestu going wide, feeds it out in front. Cleared away by John Gibson. Yakupov to Sekera. Andre Sekera. Maroon waits out in front. Letestu tips that one, and Gibson made the save. Korpakoski rips one, and that will come out when the penalty is over. Silverberg's out of the box. Yeah, the Oilers now 0 for 2. They generated one shot on that power play. 14 shots for the Oilers now, 12 for the Ducks. Gibson to save. The rebound for Cracknell, covered by John Gibson. Nail Yakupov had four shots in the last game. Watch this shot here. Quick release off the mask.
Scoreboard is Sean Horkoff, and yeah, he's getting a standing ovation from the fans for what he was able to accomplish as a member of the Edmonton Oilers. 796 regular season games, also played 35 in the playoffs, and probably the most memorable game and the most memorable goal on the part of Sean Horkoff that he is being congratulated for here at Rexall Place was back in 2006. The Oilers were down 2-0 in their series to the San Jose Sharks, but Horkoff scored in triple overtime, giving the Oilers an idea that they could make their way further into the playoffs, Drew and Kevin.
It's my least favorite hockey player on the National Hockey League is Sean Horkoff because of that goal.
Sean Horkoff playing in his 1,002nd game in the National Hockey League. Asked about him today, and he said, it's not on the back nine of my career. When you played over 1,000 games, you're kind of getting ready to make a putt on the 17th.
He's a good player, good teammate, good guy.
His team up by one, but the Oilers pressing. 8 minutes left to go in the second period. Maroon with the puck now. Maroon trying to get it to McDavid. It was cut off by Stoner. And Stoner gets it out to center. Oilers making changes. The Hall line out there. Yakupov and Dreisaitl. Vatanen to Stoner. Clayton Stoner. Hard pass across for Perry. Out of his reach. Nurse finds Hall.
What's up, Perry?
Hall brings it across the line. We'll give it to Dreisaitl. Leon Dreisaitl now to Glendening. Glendening walks in and fired that one just wide. It got by Dreisaitl.
I think he was looking at Nail Yakupov's stick. He was going for a shot pass and it just missed.
Adam Glendening with 3 points in his last two games. Knocked there by Perry, who scores. Brandon Perry took the puck away from Glendening and found the back of the net. It's 2-0 for Anaheim.
That got ugly quick. There was just a couple of mistakes by Adam Glendening after making a nice attempt to get the puck to Nail Yakupov in front. Comes back down in his own zone. And he just fumbles the puck. It's going D to D. He's got the puck, no problem. Makes a bad play there, bad pass. Gets it back and then just cannot convert on it. Brandon Peary knocks him off, turns, fires. No chance for Cam Talbot. Just about 10 seconds that Adam Glendening would like back in the game. Sometimes your windshield, sometimes you're the bug, and right there he was the bug, and it just went the wrong way for him.
Brandon Peary came over at the trade deadline from Florida. This is his 7th game in a Duck uniform. He's now got 2 goals and 2 assists. Give him 13 goals altogether on the year. And the Ducks are ahead by 2. Cam Talbot covers and gets the whistle.
Edmonton International Airport. We'll move you.
Usually you can make one mistake in your own zone and it won't cost you. You make two, it's going to cost you. Brandon Peary just goes after his man, doesn't look at the puck, knocks Glendening off of it, and then bang, puts it past Cam Talbot.
Well, you think of Brandon Peary and Jamie McGinn coming over at the trade deadline and having an impact on this team. And especially important now in the absence of David Perron.
Well, Bob Murray, what he did, stuck with Bruce Boudreau, made those changes, called out his team at the right time. Nice job as a GM.
Come into the game, 3 points back of the LA Kings, who are currently in San Jose.
Number 11, Brandon Peary.
Those teams will meet April 7th in Los Angeles.
The Ducks goal scored unassisted
by
goes wide. Hendricks.
12:48.
Can't get it by Thompson. Opportunity now for Sekera. He'll give it to Mark Fain. Fain up to Adam Cracknell. Cracknell throws that puck in. Lander. Backhand. Glove save. John Gibson. As we go downstairs to Gino.
Stuart, Kevin, just to continue the theme on Sean Horkoff, 2006 down 2-0 to the San Jose Sharks. Triple overtime. Sean Horkoff scores this goal off a pass from Ryan Smith. The Oilers would go on to win that series, take a 3-0 lead against Anaheim. And he remembers those fans. He said, you weren't even walking out in that dressing room, and you can hear the fans just exploding with excitement. And he said, the unfortunate thing is that team went as far as they could without winning the Stanley Cup.
It, without a doubt, was the loudest building I had ever been in that playoffs. Before the game started, the buzz was unbelievably loud. It was amazing.
Cassian behind the net. Lechesiu out in front. Zach Cassian with a wraparound. Lechesiu looking for it. Theodore may have prevented a goal from going in. Theodore can't get it by Korpakoski. Cassian with a puck now. Korpakoski gets by him. Corey Perry to Cam Fowler. Fowler stops up and chips it in as the Ducks make a change. Reinhardt around the boards. Korpakoski checked by Ricard Raquel. Gets it to Reinhardt. Now to Osterling. Jordan Osterling. 21 minutes, 21 seconds on average. No other rookie plays more than number 82. Badman will give it to Lindholm. Lindholm, checked there by Maroon. The puck comes to Batman, and he and Lindholm are trapped in their own zone, and they'll wait as the Kessler line hops over the boards. Lindholm goes right up the middle. He hit Kessler with a pass. Talbot now to Sekera. Maroon to the middle. McDavid to Eberle. Eberle stops inside the line. Nice pass to Nurse. Quick shot. And steered aside by John Gibson. Shane Theodore to Cam Fowler. Fowler to Kessler. Ryan Kessler now to Theodore. Theodore brings it himself across the line. He'll dish off to Cogliano. Cogliano plays it into the corner. Silverberg. Check McDavid with a pass to Nurse. Paul with speed moving in against Fowler. Fowler checks him. Getzlaf back the other way with Stuart and Peary. Getzlaf stops. Pass just out of the reach of Stewart. The net comes off the moorings and we get a whistle. Mark Letestu in a bid for an Oiler goal is stopped right there by Theodore.
Been in hockey play since 1974. Back then it was the WHA, and one of the teams the Edmonton squad used to play was the Houston Arrows. And Anaheim Ducks assistant coach Rich Preston was part of that club. In fact, he played with the Arrows for 4 years. Now, prior to Marty Howe joining Gordy, his father, and Mark, his brother, in the same line, it was actually Rich that was the other winger on the line, and back then it was called How, and Who.
That's cold.
One of the great people in the game today, Rich Preston.
Also was an assistant coach with the Calgary Flames.
San Jose Sharks, Chicago Blackhawks. He's a hockey guy, man.
Team up 2-0 with 3:41 left to go in the second period. The Oilers out shooting the Ducks. 17-14 as Dreisaitl button hooks. To the middle it goes for Yakupov. Yakupov driving the net. Yakupov in front. Hall hit the post. Taylor Hall comes oh so close as the puck comes back to Osterling. This line has gotten some chemistry in this hockey game. They just have not been rewarded. Manson snaps the shot, Talbot the save. The rebound comes to Horkoff. Matt Hendricks, hit by Thompson. Batman chops it out to center, Nurse to Cracknell. Adam Cracknell sends it around the boards. Waiting for it is Matt Hendricks. Hampus Lindholm gives it away. Fain slap shot, Gibson the save, no rebound. And we get a whistle.
As you said, Dreisaitl, Yakupov, Hall have some chemistry. Chance goes off, gets last, skate right to Taylor Hall in the slot, off the post, misses the whack, the second chance at it, I should say. And here are the most even strength points this season. Taylor Hall, I think this is an impressive stat. Seventh in the National Hockey League in even strength points. I think that's a very impressive stat, something Taylor Hall talked about being better at the start of the year. Want to stay healthy, and he wanted to be better 5-on-5. He's done that.
25 goals on the season, 21 of them have come at even strength.
50 of his 60 points. Thank you, David.
Lander, Cracknell, and Hendricks, the forward line, with Sekera and Fain on the point. Kessler lining up against Lander. Lander wins it to Sekera, snaps a shot that hit Cracknell. The puck sitting there, and it's cleared away by Sammy Vatanen. And that will be icing against Anaheim.
Sammy Vatanen back in the lineup. You miss this guy, he's a talented player. Off the faceoff, puck comes back. Sammy Vatanen just back because of his quickness. He's not a very big guy, but he's quick and he's a right-handed shooter. A quick right-handed shooter, boy, he is a valuable commodity in the National Hockey League.
Comes into this game with 7 points in his last 8 games. That was before he missed 8 with a head injury. And he continues to stay out there because the Ducks keep icing the puck.
You look at Vatanen, he's got 37 points. He's a plus 4. He's effective with and without the puck. And the right-handed shooting defensemen are very valuable, especially when you've got a team like the Ducks who have had a lot of skill on that power play. You need to have a left and a righty. Ask Mike Babcock how much he loves lefty-righties on the point.
Another guy out there now is Hamp S. Lindholm with him. He's got 28 points and 5 points in his last 5 games. Faceoff won again by Anton Lander. Korkov forces the owners to regroup as he sent Cracknell outside the line. Hendricks comes together with Vatanen. Korkov. Down the boards it goes, and Talbot touches it, and that's going to be a whistle and a power play coming up for the Anaheim Ducks. It'll be their first of the game with just over 2 minutes left to go in the period.
Bet you didn't think a pontoon could do this. Precision and performance like you've never imagined. Manitou Pontoon Boats, available at Martin Motorsports.
Adam Cracknell getting the penalty. Wow. That would be what I would refer to as a soft call.
It is the number one power play in the league, both overall and on the road. They are tied for third coming in with 52 power play goals. Ryan Getzlaf will take this draw against Mark Letestu. Getzlaf wins it right back to Sammy Vatanen. He'll give it to Cam Fowler. Fowler down low, gets by Perry. Getzlaf waiting for it. Brandon Perry is the other guy on that line. Letestu and Korpikoski are up front on this penalty kill to start. Nurse and Reinhardt on the blue line. This is Fowler. Getzlaf back to Perry. Good defensive play there by Letestu to break up the pass. And now he intercepts the pass and sends it down the ice. He'll peel off. Hendricks and Lander hop over the boards. Reinhardt joins Osterling. Vatanen to Getzlaf. Fires it around the boards. Waiting for it there is Jordan Osterling. Takes a hit from Vatanen. Brandon Perry plays it back to the point. Fowler to Perry. And back to Fowler, and it gets by number 4. Gibson plays it himself, almost gave it away to Hendricks. Hendricks has it now. Hendricks knocked down by Theodore. But Hendricks and McDavid keep it in, less than a minute to go. As McDavid goes for a skate, he'll play it back to Osterling. Osterling waits, now he'll fire it down the ice. 38 seconds left to go in the man advantage, 40 seconds left to go in the period. Raquel to Kessler. Kessler, Raquel right out in front. The shot comes on, and Talbot makes the save. The rebound cleared the length of the ice. Gibson lays it off the boards for Hampus Lindholm. Lindholm. McGinn waiting at the line as it comes back to Raquel. Raquel walks in, snaps the shot. Talbot the save, no rebound for Jamie McGinn.
Excellent effort by Matt Hendricks on the near giveaway. Well, it was a giveaway. And then Matt Hendricks beats his man, Shea Theodore. Shea Theodore wraps him up, knocks the feet out from underneath him. Referee standing right there deemed that wasn't a call. And Cam Talbot, the dying seconds of this period, makes the save, squeezes it, making sure no rebound.
8.6 seconds on the clock as Kessler wins it to Getzlaff. He snaps the shot again. Talbot the save. The puck sits there and it's picked up by Reinhardt. Crackles out of the penalty box. And right at the horn, the Oilers get a big kill. Anaheim had three shots, but do not dent the armor of the Oilers on that power play. They have a 2-0 lead, though, David, as we head to the third period.
Another goal added by Brandon Pee-wee Peary. Thank you, Jamie McGinn, for another assist on the nickname of Brandon Peary. There he is. There's Pee-wee right there.
So he's got two goals as a member of the Anaheim Ducks in seven games, 13 overall. Ryan Kessler against Connor McDavid in the faceoff circle is no contest. The number one guy against a rookie. But Connor McDavid has won 9 draws of the 13 he has taken. Ryan Getzlaff has won just 3 and lost 8. Ryan Getzlaff came into the game at 59%. Tonight, he has won just 28% of his draws.
That tells me that the Oilers have been ready since the get-go. They've been engaged in this game.
McDavid, Maroon, and Eberle, along with Sekera and Fain, to start this third period. Getzlaff wins that draw, and it's cleared in by Jakob Silverberg. Talbot plays it around the board. Silverberg keeps it in for Cogliano. Cogliano's shot hit the side of the net. Silverberg's got it. Silverberg. Plays it back to the point. Fowler lets it go. It is blocked by Eberle. Eberle backhands it in. Eberle still has it. Goes cross-ice. Opportunity in front for Maroon. Gibson was down. Maroon a chance to score against his old team on his first matchup against the Ducks.
That was so close.
We saw that in the game against Los Angeles. His second goal of the night, very similar. Gibson sends it around the boards. Kept in by Yakupov. Centering pass, picked off. There is Hampus Lindholm to play it off the glass and out. Osterley is checked by McGinn, but does manage to get the puck into Duck territory. Lindholm finds Perry on the near side. Corey Perry will backhand it in. Ricard Raquel can't get it to his line mate, Jamie McGinn. And the Oilers get the puck out. Corey Perry scored in the first period. It was Brandon Peary in the second. That's where we stand. The last time these teams met was a 2-1 overtime game on February the 26th in favor of the Ducks. The Oilers won the first matchup in overtime, 4-3. Dreisaitl checked at the line. He's back into his own zone. He will give it to Andre Sekera. Sekera goes right up the middle for Kassian. He had Vatanen all over him. Ryan Getzlaff. Clayton Stoner. Back to the captain. Peary. Waits. Tried to get that slap pass into Getzlaff. Getzlaff. Drop pass. Vatanen. He lost an edge. And the Oilers try and take advantage. Here comes Kassian. Kassian stops. Feeds it in front. The big rebound is picked up by Peary. Here he gets the line, shoots it in. The Ducks want to make a change. They will be home to play Calgary on Wednesday and then Vancouver on Friday. That will be the 7th straight game against Canadian teams. They're 2-1-1 here in the 5th game of their 5-game road trip.
It is a long road trip at this time of the year, for sure.
Ranked 15th on the road. They're 18, 14, and 5. Osterley. check. And as the puck sits behind the net, the Oilers trying to get it free. Lander digging for it. Been given a big hit there by Cracknell. Knocked down by Hendricks. Quick shot from Osterley, rattles off the glass. Talbot, or Garbutt, picks it up on the near side. He will give it to Horkoff, and Horkoff content just to backhand that puck out. For the Oilers, this is the start of their final three-game homestand. They've got Calgary in here, but not until next Saturday. And then Vancouver on Wednesday, and we will close out the history of the Edmonton Oilers here at Rexall on that night.
5 o'clock start that night.
Ceremony to follow, and we'll have it all for you here on Sportsnet. Nurse right in front of his own bench, checked by Silverberg, moving in with Cogliano. Cogliano, Silverberg slaps the shot, and Talbot makes the save. Well, there's the first whistle. We've got 16-12 left to go in the third.
Patrick Maroon would have loved this. Entry is kept in by Jordan Eberle. Long pass to McDavid. McDavid just misses on Patrick Maroon. His feet are turned. He's thinking pass all the way, and Patrick just can't get a stick down on time. And then there's Patrick Maroon leaning over, and oh, he should have had that.
Maroon has got 5 points in his last two games, including a pair of goals against LA on Saturday.
Hard slash, he's going to be a penalty down here.
Hall, Dreisaitl, cross ice for Yakupov, touched by Rickard Rakell. And the Oilers get their third power play of the game.
The Brick, saving you more on furniture, mattresses, appliances, and big screen TVs.
Tonight's Safeway $1 Million Score and Win grand prize winner will receive a trip for two to a Dreams Resort and Spa, courtesy of RedTag.ca, where Canada shops for great travel deals. Tonight's grand prize winner is Tony Bunai of Spruce Grove, Alberta. Congratulations, Tony. Shop at Safeway today, and you could be our next lucky winner.
Corey Perry is in the penalty box for slashing. Osterley at the line. Hall, Dreisaitl, McDavid, and Eberle join the lone defenseman for the Oilers as Eberle has the puck in the corner. He'll play it to McDavid. McDavid back up top for Osterley. He'll give it back to the rookie. McDavid goes cross ice. Eberle steps a shot. Gibson, the glove save. He'll hang on.
Jordan Eberle gets a beautiful opportunity. Times is perfectly coming off the boards. Back to Connor McDavid. Creates that own shooting lane. It's still not quite quick enough. It's that just that little bit of handle that allows Gibson to get over. Although in support of Jordan Eberle, that pass was just a tad bit behind him. He can't one-time it from where it was.
Dreisaitl and Kessler again, and Kessler protesting. Look where Kessler will get, how low he'll get, and he wins that draw. Vatanen sends it down the ice. The Oilers with 40 power play goals this season, 21 of them have come here at Rexall Place. Hall, McDavid, across ice for Dreisaitl. Back to Eberle. Eberle, Horkoff on the intercept, he will give it to Getzlaff. Moving in, 3-on-1, shorthanded, Getzlaff, broken up by Osterley. And the rookie thwarts that play and allows the Oilers to come back with Hall. Hall stops up. Taylor Hall plays it back to the point. Osterley waiting for it there. He'll come to the near side for Eberle. Jordan Eberle down low for McDavid. McDavid to Hall. Hall snaps a shot off of Fowler's stick. To the corner it goes. Hall waiting for it. Dreisaitl is in front. Osterley now to Eberle. Eberle looking for the stick of Dreisaitl. That missed the target. 40 seconds of power play time remaining. Osterley at the blue line. Throws it towards the net. Hall looking for the rebound. McDavid with it now. McDavid down to Hall. Hall back for McDavid. McDavid out in front! Cleared by Clayton Stoner. And finished off by Ryan Getzlaff.
Had opportunities. They've had really good chances. Gibbs is just keeping everything out. That was an unbelievable save the last one.
22 shots for the Oilers. Chance for one last rush. Maroon on the near side. Out there with Korpakoski. Yakupov. Letestu feeds it in front. Maroon lets a shot go. Pad save by Gibson. Penalty is over. Two shots. Perry out of the box. Good play by Letestu to break up that pass intended for Cogliano. Oilers now 0 for 3 with a man advantage. Secker around the boards, waiting for it, is Hendricks. Matt Hendricks fires it in. Gibson will corral it there for Hampus Lindholm. Lindholm takes the bump as he sends it around to McGinn. McGinn down the ice. Perry checked by Fain. Raquel carries on for the Ducks. Sent into the boards there by Adam Krechel. Hendricks and Landers start away. Pass for Nurse. Nurse to the middle. And that's broken up by Stoner. Now an opportunity for Perry. Perry and McGinn. Here's Perry to McGinn. McGinn's shot. Stopped by Talbot. Reaches out and covers the puck and gets the whistle. A little help from your friends always helps when you're a rookie goaltender. Watch Horkoff and Stoner.
The only Nurse who is in sporting action this evening. It's difficult to get Darnell and Key in the same place because their schedules often conflict at the Pan Am Games. They were together. They were even together for a nice interview on the Tim and Sid show. And, of course, Darnell has had the opportunity to watch his sister represent Canada, but he's never watched her play for UConn, the University of Connecticut, who were in action tonight and were winners, so they moved to the Final Four as both Nurses for their respective teams are Kia's the success.
Wow.
That was well done.
Kid sharp tonight.
Yeah, I didn't see that one coming.
Yep. Way to go, Gino. Darnell Nurse, third in the league among rookies when it comes to ice time. He is also second in hits. His team, though, trails by two. Secker at the point. Down low for Maroon, out with McDavid and Eberle. Fain steps up against Peary. Peary chops it down the ice. The race is on. Silverberg gets there first. Sekera checked by Silverberg, along with Kessler and Cogliano. Cogliano with a steal. Andrew Cogliano at the blue line. Eberle stole that pass and starts back. He'll give it to Maroon. Maroon just inside the line. Cross ice over the stick of McDavid. And a penalty coming up. And it will be holding. And Hampus Lindholm
I think it's Connor.
Spun around by Connor McDavid, and he will go to the box.
I think this could have been either or both of them or neither of them. So Connor McDavid just misses the pass, goes in the corner. They both entangle. They both wrap up with each other. Lindholm goes down. It's each guy wrapping each other up. Do you not have to let that one go and just let them play it out? That's a, I'm sorry, I thought the previous call was soft that I talked about. That's a horrible call.
I'm not paying your fines.
Okay.
Second power play for Anaheim. Fowler to Vatanen. Out there with Peary, Getzlaff, and Perry. Randy Peary leaves it for Getzlaff. Back to the point. It comes for Fowler. Fowler waits. Now he'll give it to Vatanen. Steps into a slap shot, and he whistled that one high. Getzlaff. Back to Fowler. He'll give it back to the captain. Ryan Getzlaff feeds it down low for Perry. Perry comes all the way back to Fowler. His shot. And that one gets deflected into the netting, and checking his stick and finding it breaking was Mark Letestu.
You talked about it earlier, Kevin. The first 33 games, the Pacific Division ranked there in last place, and the numbers are just ugly. And the last 41 games, unbelievable winning percentage, 756, and now they're buying the LA Kings to be top of the division to have that home ice advantage in the first couple rounds of the playoffs.
It is 1-1 in that game between LA and San Jose. Getzlaff drops for Perry. A nice play by Lander to break it up. And that puck, as Lander is calling, went off the glass before it went out. He was quick to point that out.
Yes. I love that rule just for the simple fact that you've got no.
Buddy,
sorry, went up.
Loses the challenge.
Maybe it was his stick that made the sound on the boards. Let's have a look at it.
Now watch him bang the glass.
Yeah, he's it banging is. The glass, but the Anaheim Ducks are calling. We got a whack there, too, from Corey Perry. Anton's banging the glass. Corey Perry is saying it's right out, and now it's a 5-on-3 for a dynamite power play.
They have scored 3 5-on-3 goals this year. The Anaheim Ducks will have a minute and 13 to work with. Huge kill coming up now for the Edmonton Oilers. Zekera.
2 minutes for delay of game.
Got the puck to Kropotkowski, and he got it down the ice.
Patrick Maroon is up on his bench. He's yelling at the official for the hold that Corey Perry had. Patrick Maroon's really giving it to any referee that's nearby.
Kessler back to Ryan Getzlaff. Getzlaff directing traffic. Getzlaff takes his time. He'll feed Fowler. There is Vatanen. Slap pass for Getzlaff. Broke it up. He'll work it back to Fowler. Again, Vatanen had his stick ready. Now he'll peel off as Perry's got the puck. Kessler out in front. Here's Fowler's shot. Rebound for Getzlaff. Covered by Talbot. The puck is loose. And finally, Talbot gets the whistle.
So we showed Mark Letestu talking to Darnell Nurse in the first period. He actually settles Patrick Maroon down because Patrick Maroon is upset at this. That hook, that trip right there by Ryan Getzlaff off the faceoff that allowed the Ducks to get the puck and keep it in the zone. Patrick Maroon was standing on the bench and Mark Letestu just went and said, hey, settle down, take it easy. So Letestu, again, proving to be a good leader.
Hendricks now will line up against Kessler. Hendricks. Kessler wins the draw back to Fowler. Fowler will give it to Theodore, get it back again. This is Getzlaff down low. Great battle in front. Kessler against Hendricks. Fowler goes to Perry right out in front. And he tried to get it to Getzlaff. Theodore will now give it to Fowler quickly to Getzlaff. Getzlaff moving in and the pass intercepted by Hendricks and fired the length of the ice. And Connor McDavid is ready to get back out there. It'll be 5-on-4 now for the next 45 seconds. Two shots on that 5-on-3. Raquel. He'll bring it in, send it around the boards. Osterley giving a bump. Fights that off. Can't get it by him again. Back to the point it comes. Shea Theodore. He'll go cross ice. Hampus Lindholm. Ricard Raquel. Raquel checked by Sekera. This is Theodore. Side of the net. Jamie McGinn thought he had a goal, went up off the crossbar and straight down.
We'll have to have a look at that one.
10 seconds to go and the penalty to Anton Lander. Theodore. Gains the line, fires it in. Talbot trying to slow it down for Darnell Nurse. The penalty is over. Teams at even strength. Stewart works it back to Stoner. Stoner fakes the shot. Now he'll let a wrister go. And a blocker save for Cam Talbot. Hall with speed moving in against Stoner. Drop pass for Draisaitl. Back to Hall. Hall centers it out in front. And it's cleared by Raquel. Outlet pass and racing after it is Thompson. But it will be icing, much to the chagrin of number 44.
Let's have a look. Jamie McGinn. Just as the dying seconds of the Shark or the Oilers penalty kill, tips it up off the crossbar. One more time off Cam Talbot, off the crossbar, and stays just out. Well, that's as close as it's going to get.
Ducks now with 24 shots, the Oilers 23. 8:49 left to go in regulation time. McDavid wins the draw. Back up top it comes. Sekera steps into a shot, and that was blocked by Nate Thompson. Maroon given a shove there by Stoner. The puck in the corner still alive. McDavid digs it out. Maroon to Eberle. Eberle back up top for Fane. A wrist shot. Gibson got a piece of that and sent it up into the netting. Rogers, Oilers Hockey from Rexall Place, right here on Sportsnet.
On Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey, it's a matchup of size and skill. As Erik Karlsson and the Senators take on Dustin Byfuglien and the Jets at 7:30 Eastern, 5:30 Mountain. Following that at 10 Eastern, 8 Mountain, Johnny Gaudreau and the Calgary Flames are in Anaheim to take on Ryan Getzlaff and the Ducks. That's Wednesday night on Sportsnet. And speaking of the Flames, we will join them in progress right away off to Glendale, Arizona. They are currently in the second period, tied at 1.
Gene, here's their 8:24 left to go in the third period. Yakupov scores! Kale Yakupov off the feed from Taylor Hall, and John Gibson never saw it.
And he's getting kind of a standing ovation, sort of. Not by everybody. Good work by Taylor Hall and Leon Draisaitl off his faceoff. Big smiles from everybody. Draws the 50-50 draw. Taylor Hall wins the battle. Boom. It's the battle by Taylor Hall. What did Louis DeBrusque talk about when Taylor Hall's engaged? He's a heavy, strong guy to play against. He wins the battle, and Yakupov with that quick release.
And a delayed celebration. As Nail Yakupov gets his first goal in 13 games, and it's a 2-1 game here.
There was some boos earlier when he was touching the puck. A few faint ones. Not now.
Here comes McDavid. Backhand, Gibson the save. Big rebound back to Sekera. He'll let it go through traffic. McDavid just missed. Everly trying to feed it out in front. Gibson scrambling as the puck comes to Fane. He'll let it go. Everly shot! Hit the side of the net. Oilers all over the Ducks now. Fane with the puck. He'll give it to Sekera. Andre Sekera off the end boards for Maroon. Maroon, McDavid, and Everly following up on the shift from Hall and Yakupov and Draisaitl. Fane can't keep it in. He'll chase. The Oilers back into their own zone. The Ducks want to make a change. Sekera will wait as the Oilers scramble to get off. Vatanen brings it in. It was like trying to squeeze into a Volkswagen when you were in college in the 60s.
The Crown College.
Hall moving in. Given a bump there by Stoner. Fans here at Rexall coming alive. Hall with the puck now. Hall feeds it out in front. Kept in at the line by Reinhardt. Vatanen plays it around the boards. Reinhardt waiting for it. Reinhardt drops it back for Yakupov. Yakupov unable to keep it in. Nurse comes over and takes it away from Raquel. He'll play it off the boards for Hall. Hall winding up in neutral ice across the blue line. Hall hangs on, lays it back to the point. Letestu keeps it in, lets his shot go, just go wide. Another chance in the backhand for Letestu. That one missed. Getzlaff with it now. He'll play it to Stoner. Stoner off the boards for McGinn. McGinn checked by Osterling. 26 shots for the Oilers, 24 for the Ducks. Letestu bangs it in. Fowler back to get it around the boards for Horkoff. Horkoff for Garbutt. Out to center it goes. Nate Thompson with it now. Thompson. Pass for Garbutt. Connor McDavid flying down the right side. Here comes McDavid. Connor McDavid stopped by Gibson. McDavid carries on from the corner. Sekera at the point. Andre Sekera. Shot was broken up by Thompson. Now it is Horkoff. As Thompson makes his way slowly to the Anaheim bench. Garbutt snaps a shot that misses. Cogliano keeps it in on the near side. Ryan Garbutt turns, lets it go. That one hit the side of the net. Cogliano, Kessler, and Garbutt. Now Silverberg hops over the boards as the Oilers come back. Jakob Silverberg gets it to Hampus Lindholm, to Cogliano. He'll backhand it in. 5 minutes, 14 seconds left to go here in regulation time. Silverberg from behind the net plays it out in front. Osterley had tied up Kessler. Draisaitl with it now. He'll pump it in. Maroon. Hard hit. And that. Josh Manson just getting up now. And he will make his way slowly
to the bench as a penalty is coming up to Patrick Maroon. Sixth attackers on the ice for the Ducks. Hampus Lindholm to Silverberg. Back to Lindholm. Lindholm drop pass for Perry. Perry. We'll give it to Getzlaff. Getzlaff back to Peary. Brandon Peary, Getzlaff hammers a shot off the glass high. Getzlaff with it now. Getzlaff taking his time. Dreisaitl will touch it. And a penalty coming. A scary moment for Josh Manson as he does the splits into the boards. His team will
reporting at a critical time. Let's go back though, right after the Oilers score, Connor McDavid just goes around Lindholm, inside, outside, backhand, just misses on the rebound, and then in front finds Jordan Eberle. Jordan Eberle can't get it up to the spot where he wants, just misses, and again, the speed of Connor McDavid around Fowler to the net. Connor McDavid, after the Oilers scored, he was putting on a clinic.
Huge kill for the Oilers as Letestu set to take this draw against Kessler. Off a scramble, the Oilers have possession. Letestu and Korpakoski. Korpakoski, and Letestu is offside.
Build an exclusive Oilers fan cave in your new Coventry home and live every day like it's game day. Coventry Homes, the preferred builder of the Edmonton Oilers.
First winner in our score and win contest tonight on behalf of Safeway, along with Kellogg's or Akashi Cereal, is Angela Ilchuk of Spruce Grove, has won the Salton Harley Pasternak Power Blender on the goal by Neil Yakupov at 11:40 of this third period. That's made it 2-1, but now the Oilers penalty killers have to go to work. 1:34 left to go on the penalty to Patrick Maroon. 3:38 on the clock. Kessler put it by McGinn. Opportunity for Reinhardt. Sends it around the boards. Kessler keeps it in. Nurse. Kessler comes up with it. Gets it to Lindholm. Lindholm was alone, but he couldn't get that puck to settle down. He'll play it back to Shea Theodore. Hendricks out there now on the penalty kill along with Anton Lander. Nurse changes. Sekera will join Osterlin. Lindholm drops it back for Peary. He bobbles it, but he does get it to Theodore. Now to Getzlaff. Ryan Getzlaff at center, being shadowed there by Anton Lander. He'll go back as the Ducks make changes. They're in no hurry right now. 2:50 on the clock. 40 seconds of power play time remaining. Fowler for the pass for Vatanen. Sammy Vatanen lays it down low. Sekera's got it. Sekera rips it around the boards. It hit Peary. He'll keep it in for Brandon Peary. Peary on the far side. Vatanen is there. Fowler on the blue line with him. Gets left. Being watched by Hendricks. Gets it back to Vatanen. Vatanen to Fowler. Fowler takes his time. Fowler down low for Corey Peary. Works his way out in front. Lander can't get it by Vatanen. His shot is blocked. Peary picks it up on the corner. 5 seconds left to go with the penalty to Patrick Maroon. Fowler with the puck now. Vatanen waits, beats it out in front. Peary with it as the penalty is over. Maroon is on the ice. 5-on-5, but 2 minutes remaining here in the third period. Getzlaff takes his time in the corner. He'll give it to Brandon Peary as the Ducks make changes with the puck in the order zone. Getzlaff backhands it in. Peary circles the net. Corey Peary works it out in front, lost the handle. The Oilers have a chance now. And the pass for Maroon out of his reach. And that's going to be icing against the Edmonton Oilers as we go downstairs to Gino.
Well, Drew and Kevin, we'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the fans that entered this year's Safeway $1 million score and win promotion here on Sportsnet. Congratulations to all those people who've won fabulous Safeway score and win prizes each time the Oilers scored. Keep watching Sportsnet for more great Safeway promotions, and you could be our next lucky winner.
1 minute, 40 seconds left to go here in the third period. The fifth and final meeting between the Edmonton Oilers and the Anaheim Ducks. Lander against Kessler. From the faceoff, Sekera to Osterling. Keep our eye on Cam Talbot. Lander gets the puck in. Here comes Talbot. He's at the hash marks as the owners Eberle, Maroon, Talbot headed to the bench. There's the shot. Gibson makes the save and falls awkwardly. Six attackers on the ice. McDavid from the corner. McDavid back to Nurse at the point. Nurse down low for Hall. Hall checked by Kessler. Ryan Kessler and Hall go down. And Reinhardt can't keep the puck in. Less than a minute to go. Nurse has to wait as the Oilers clear. They do now. And a shot towards the empty net goes wide. It's going to be tipped, so no icing. 50 seconds left to go. The Ducks able to get a change in. Hall has to circle to get away from Getzlaff. Now he'll go cross ice. Fowler on the intercept. Fowler uses the glass, gets the puck to the line. Hall plays it back to Osterling. 30 seconds left to go. Sekera. And offside is the call at the Duck blue line.
Put your hands together.
27.8 seconds left. Now we'll be looking at timeout. The play you want to set up, but it's unique in this situation because the play is outside. The faceoff is outside of the zone.
Let's take a look at the play of the game. It's brought to you by Rogers NHL Game Center Live. Follow your team on any screen from anywhere.
First goal is a big goal, but it's so beautifully executed. The breakout pass, the touch pass, it creates a two-on-one and then finished off by a big-time goal scorer, Corey Perry. Head up, perfect shot, right up in the top corner. Everything about that play was textbook. That's why it's our Rogers play of the game.
Corey Perry now on a four-game point streak, his 31st goal of the year, and his 23rd in his career against the Oilers in game number 43. 27.8 seconds on the clock. The faceoff just outside the blue line. The net empty. Leon Draisaitl set to take the draw against Ryan Kessler. Maroon, Eberle, Hall, McDavid, Sekera. From the faceoff, Draisaitl. Back to Sekera, near side for Hall. Hall will send it in. Fowler stops it. Cam Fowler flips it down towards the empty net. That will miss, and another icing coming up against the Ducks.
Interesting choice by Fowler though, right?
With just a one goal lead, he decides to go for the empty net. He hasn't had a goal in 11 games. That may have been the reason.
And that's why Getzlaff was coming over to say something to him. Maybe he was looking for just a flip and some backspin to get it to die before it crossed the goal line.
The owners dominating in the faceoff circle. They need to do it again here with Draisaitl against Kessler. From the draw, scramble. Getzlaff working hard to get it out. Can't do it. Hall brings it in and the whistle goes.
I don't think this was offside. It didn't look like for me it was offside up here, but we'll have a look at this. The linesman called a late offside.
Mark Wheeler.
Puck gets kicked. I don't think that's offside.
Wow. So the faceoff outside the blue line with 7.2 seconds to go. Maroon with a big hit. Sekera will not get the shot. John Gibson gets his 18th victory. The Anaheim Ducks get two big points as they've got 94 on the season now.
Yeah, there's a little bit of nastiness there. Patty Maroon still upset over the ending of the game, and he and Chris Stewart became entangled with each other.
Anaheim's five-game road trip. They are 3-1-1.
Rogers Oilers Hockey. Brought to you by Rogers. With Rogers, stay connected wherever your day takes you. By Molson Canadian, diehard fan and
proud partner of the Edmonton Oilers. By Ford, official automotive partner of the Edmonton Oilers. By Scotiabank, you're richer than you think. And by the Rexall family of pharmacies.
Three stars are brought to you by Molson Canadian, diehard fan and proud partner of the Edmonton Oilers.
First goal in 13 games as Louis DeBrus said he's played very well and had some great chemistry with Taylor Hall. So Neil Yakupov third, Taylor Hall second, first assist and three shots, and he was dynamite. John Gibson with 27 big saves, a lot of them dynamite chances.
Well, we've got more hockey action for you here on Sportsnet West as the Calgary Flames are in the desert to take on the Arizona Coyotes. That game late in the second period.